Thank you. Congratulations. Amazing. What an incredible project and incredible partners. I can't thank you enough. Our mission is very simple. We try to foster stewardship of our beloved river. And the way we do that is through four primary pillars. We do it through arts and culture implementation, education, environmental, and recreational opportunities along the river. Our premise is if we can get people to engage the river, to love the river, they will take care of the river. And in taking care of the river, we will take care of ourselves. And so the way we've done that over time, so far, we're only 15 years old, but so far, through private investment, every single dollar counts. We've invested $26 million in art and architecture and amenities along our beloved river. On what we call the Mission Reach, we have our wonderful World Heritage missions along the reach. The trick was, we have all these wonderful paths and paddling trails and hiking and biking, but the people who built the missions were very smart, and they built them off the river so they wouldn't get flooded. So the trick is, how do you get people that are running and biking and enjoying the river to know that there's this amazing resource only 500 miles away? And the Art Master Plan said, for the project, said, let's put art portals, let's put public art portals adjacent to each mission and share the themes that the National Park has applied to the different missions. And so, in commissioning this piece for Mission Espada, we looked for artists that could sort of help us mold the nature of the theme. And in shortlisting, we were so lucky to find Margarita Carrera. If you know her work, you know that it always involves story, culture, and community. And community being the important part, because you always draw people in. And that was the important part of what we were trying to do, draw people in. So for our 300th anniversary, we're bringing more than 300 stories. We're bringing 800 pieces, I think, right now, between the large and the small scale pieces. This is a portal project that's between the mission and the river. This Arbol de la Vida is 80 feet wide and almost 40 feet high. So look up to the ridge line for a second. It's about as tall as this building.
It's about 25 feet up to
the bottom. To the bottom. So,
yeah,
40
feet.
So it's big. This is an amazing piece, and all of your stories, all of the strength and beauty of San Antonio and all of its cultures being brought together into one piece. Tells our collective story, I think is the beautiful part of what we're trying to do here. So I can't thank you enough for bringing that concept to us and for your strength of vision and realizing it. It's going to be an amazing piece. We'll be unveiling, we hope, early May. We're struggling a little bit with fiesta dates right now. We don't want to unveil when it's about flowers. So we're working on dates right now. But keep an eye out, I'm sure, Margarita's website, margaritacabrera.com, or our website, sarfoundation.org, or perhaps even
yourself.org.
We'll keep everyone informed as the project gets assembled. So please keep an eye out for that. And I'd like to pitch one other thing for Go Art. Woo! Go Art!
Woo!
In January of next year, we are unveiling Confluence Park, which is an environmental education park in the south side. And the reason why I bring it up, with our arts and culture and education and ecology outreach, we need arts programming to come inhabit our park. So I look forward to working with Kellen and the crew to bring the arts, playing their painting, sculpting to our facility.
Yeah.
And we reveal it on January 17th. So mark it in your calendar to go see us.
Woo!